Okay, so we had a discussion, and I was talking about, like, yeah, I was just telling Dexter because a couple of things at the event bothered me, and I'm not going to get into detail about that yet. That's another podcast for another day. We'll just be as diplomatic as possible.
Sometimes you don't like being diplomatic. I can tell it bothers your soul.
Yeah, but it does.
I understand, but you have to learn when.
I'm learning time and place.
Yes, time and place.
You don't want to ruin.
Learn that as you go.
You don't want to ruin a lot, especially someone like me, who may or may not be, you know, talking to a lot of new, different people with some things that may be in the works or may not.
Yeah, I get it. I get it.
That's the best way that I can put that, right?
I get it.
Without being so direct, but I was talking about how, yo, I got very jaded very quickly by this industry, just in general.
And we're talking about the sports media industry.
Yeah, we had this long, and we've had conversations about this. And what I'm wondering is, because it can happen very quickly if you're not one of these people who wants to play the game. Now, there are a lot of people who do. There are a lot of people who like to play along and, you know, sort of finesse things in certain ways. When you're not one of those people, and when you want to be authentic and go about your business and be yourself, how difficult has it been for you, and how difficult do you know it to be just in general to sort of navigate through when you're figuring all this out?
Well, I think that when you're a minority, you have these moments of, especially in the workplace, where you understand where keeping it real can go wrong. And you're trying to navigate and move your way. So you have to learn, as somebody, I got some good advice from somebody the other day, you have to know when you have the equity to then be able to take the steps and be able to use your voice when you need to as a minority in this media landscape. To answer your question, how hard has it been to do that? It's always been hard because you know, a lot of times for us Black and Latino folks coming into the sports media space, you find yourself as the only one in a job. You still do. Let me explain to people. And I was talking to a group of friends about this over dinner a couple weeks ago, and we all work in different industries. It does not get any easier as you move up.
Oh, great.
The more you move up, the less of you will actually see.
Even in 2019.
In 2019, the more you move up, the higher you ascend in your career. And this is for a lot of minorities in a lot of industry, the less of people that look like you do see, which is sad. And I think when you're starting out, it's hard because you want to be authentic to yourself and do what you have to do. To me, the best way you can be authentic to yourself is to create your own platforms, because then nobody can tell you what you can do. Nobody can tell us what we want to do or say on this podcast. Nobody can tell Brian what he wants to do or say on his show that he's doing.
And especially don't tell me what to wear.
Right. Nobody can tell me what to do in terms of creating the content created, whether it's sideline stories or whatever. And so that's where I understand where the true freedom comes in. That's how you build your brand. That's how you build your stuff. However, what comes frustrating is you still have to navigate in the spaces of us. We obviously have to work for companies, other different people, and sometimes do things where...
Work with companies.
They don't work with, yes. Work with, they don't look at it that way. I've realized how clear that becomes.
Don't care.
You have to learn how to navigate in those spaces and still do what you want to do, but also you got to remember you're creating for somebody else's dream. I think that, for me, I was jaded by that until I started creating my own. Once I started creating my own, it doesn't mean those frustrations still don't arise with how sometimes other people want. But if I always know I have an outlet to create my own thing,
yeah,
I'm good. Because I'm not as frustrated because I'm always like, oh, I've here, I could talk about this. You know what I'm saying? I've here, I can do this. I can create this here.
That does take a lot of money and resources, though.
Yeah, but
I've learned that from experience.
But here's the way I look at it.
Okay.
It is, and this is specifically for Black and Latino people in this industry, it is like you're taking care of your mental health while in the industry. It is the way you have to do it and you're going to do it. Because if you do, because we have to understand there's a lot of trauma, there's a lot of stress dealing in these spaces where people don't understand you, where you come from, or you don't see any people at the top that look like you. So the thing that has been therapeutic for me, and I won't go into this story because many people have heard it on this podcast. You could go check out Side Hustle with Brian and listen to my story on there too.
Episode 8, yes.
There were people, and it was frustrating. I got jaded when people tried to block me and stop me. So creating Backpack Broadcasting, who powers this podcast, it powers other content you've seen, that was therapy for me. That helped me. If I didn't have that, I wouldn't be sitting here in, on many fronts. But it's therapeutic because I always was like, okay, this is my safe haven. This is my space. When I'm editing a podcast, when I'm editing a show, when I'm thinking about ideas or putting out stuff, we're doing highlights, it's therapeutic for me because I know I'm always doing something for me in the way I want. You got to find your therapy because you ain't going to find it in some of these jobs.
Yeah, and I've also learned with some of these jobs is that in most cases, they're looking for someone to fill this role. They're not looking for you necessarily. There is a difference.
Yeah, the quicker you learn that is the quicker you play the game, get your equity, and then move it into the way that you use the equity to make the game be the way you want.
And I
want to
explain that a little more because people have to understand – companies, yes, like you said, they don't see it that way. When I say work with instead of work for and things of that nature, a lot of companies, they don't see that way because they're looking to fill a role. There's maybe an application out or just in general, there's just some sort of opening at some place for X amount of dollars. They just want someone to fill that role. That doesn't mean they're invested in you. Now, that can change upon your arrival, you know, depending on who's there and depending on how things go. But for the most part... and it could also get worse.
Oh, it can change the other way.
Yeah, right. But for the most part, yes, they're just looking for, and this is not a knock on every single company ever, because there are some good companies out there that you can work and they'll care about you and things of that nature. They're harder to find. But for the most part, like, yes, there are some out there. So this is not just a general broad brush stroke across every single media outlet ever. But there are places that, yes, they're looking to fill an opening as opposed to let's figure out what to do with this person. Let's figure out what to do with Dexter, with Brian. How could we sort of develop some sort of ideas and we could all play to each other's strengths here? It's not always that same thing. I've been in probably both situations already. I feel like I've already been through a lot. I've been through both situations already in different places. You know what I mean?
So. Yeah. I mean, look, in terms of media, I think development is lacking. You know, we've had many discussions about media. We had it on a recent podcast. We even talked about certain things within the media with Howard Beck. You know, when we had Christina Tapper up here, mm-hmm. I thought one of the best things she talked about was, you know, and she went through some things in leaving her job and finding her happiness. And I think one of the things she talked about was in management, knowing really wanting to develop, really caring about you as a person. What you will understand and what Brian is saying is, and I can say this from experience, freelancing, working full time.
Yeah.
The good companies, the good people you freelance for, they care about you in terms of you as a person and what you do. You're not just somebody just coming in to do a job. The companies that don't, I think those companies have bad culture. Mm-hmm. I think that it'll hurt those companies in the long run. I think a lot of companies, they skate by where they don't have to value that, but they don't realize that most of their employees are not happy, yeah. Right? You want to work for people, work with people,
yes,
where you feel like, yo, they're going to go through a wall for you, you're going to go through a wall for them. That's how it should be.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, that's not how it is for a lot of people. If you can't develop people, if you don't spend the time to talk to them, if you don't empower them, some people may sit there and be like, oh, Dexter, what do you know about this? No, I do know. The reason I know this is I used to work in a school, St. Francis College, where I was in charge of younger people who were working under me. So I learned a lot in that role about how to lead people, leadership.
I was one of those people.
How to tell people this and empower those people to do great things. And I feel confident in saying that I think a lot of those people who were in that position underneath me, I empowered them to do great things. It was never me being a taskmaster or directive. I asked them how things were. I still talk to those people today. How's your family? How are these things going on? How are you balancing your relationship? Because all that stuff matters. And I've worked in places where people don't ask you stuff like that. That's what Christina was talking about when she was sitting right there.
Yeah.
Those things are little things that matter. Those are the things that help you from being jaded, because then you're in a situation where it's like, yo, this person cares about me. This person cares about developing me. Development and just care for human beings is such a lost art in many media companies, because a lot of it is about pumping out the content and not necessarily caring about the people who are either creating or facilitating that content. And that's the problem. Again, you can't, if you're in a company like that, don't look for the hope in that company, because chances are that company is not going to change just because you tell them to.
Yeah.
And in fact, the things that you do that might be against that, if you actually care about your happiness, they're probably going to push back on that. And that, what I'll say to people out there is the company's probably not for you. So I'm not saying, hey, go quit your job tomorrow. What I, because it's not, I understand people got to pay bills. But what I am saying is you got to make a choice at that point where you have to be like, yo, is this it for me? Does this affect my happiness? And how do I make, what's my exit strategy? And Christina talked about that too. So we're talking about this now. People want to go back. If you missed that episode, listen to that episode.
I think that's 84.
84. I think that's 84. We listened to, we talked about a lot of that.
And she's coming back soon, by the
yes.
way.
Yes. But we know it's okay to admit that you're jaded in this industry because there are things that will do that. There are things
more
that
so
do.
This year. More so this year.
I think you got to find your outlet in this weird thing. It's like kind of creating your own outlet in whatever that is. Because when you create for yourself,
Side Hustle is doing all right.
And nobody can kill that. That's the place. You can look back at that and be really proud of something. You know, I was sending, real quick aside, I was last week, and you know why, I was sending some links of some stuff that we had done to somebody, and I was sending them, and I was in a hotel room packing up to come back home from some place from work, and I just had on these sideline stories we did. And I was like listening to them in the background, I was watching as I was packing, and, you know, I was really like, I hadn't watched some of them in a while, and I was like, oh man, like, I'm really proud of that stuff we did. Even though we've done some of that stuff 2-3 years ago, it makes you happy that's something that you created, that's always mine, and I did it my way and with my people. And by my people, I mean all the team of people that helped us work on these things. That matters. So for me personally, that's how I deal with it. You're always going to be jaded. And sadly, walking around as a minority in this world, you have a lot of reasons to be angry and jaded.
Bro.
And working in the industry, there's a lot of reasons to be angry and jaded. That's not okay personally, and that shouldn't be happening. But it is the America and world we live in, so you got to find out ways to deal with your... It's just like anything else. You got to take care of mental health, physical health, your job health. So you got to figure out a way to take care of that. Did I leave you speechless? Nah, man. Like, it's important. Like, you have to figure out the ways to take care of that.
Yeah, I mean, I will say this. That's also a problem in music. In terms of lack of development, that was a point that you touched on earlier that matters. Because now, I don't know, like, has stuff really changed? Was it not like this before where people just wanted quick fixes and people weren't developing people? Because I get the sense that back in the day, not just music, but in general, that one, I feel like there were more jobs available. Two, there was definitely more development going on. Like, you saw artist development, and in media industry, you saw sort of, I don't know, talent development, I guess you would say, right? You saw more of those things that you're not necessarily seeing now because a lot of companies are just trying to do quick fixes, patch things up.
Well, I think it's two...
Fill these roles like we talked about before.
I think it's two things. Like, I do... There's undoubtedly there were more jobs back in the day across all industries, and there probably was more development.
There's definitely more freelance jobs now. Hey, if you want to blog for a few $100s a month, I can show you a few places.
Yeah, but... So some people, it's weird because in things like that, people be like, well, there's more jobs, there's more openings and stuff for people to write, do stuff on camera. You're bringing up another point.
But at some point, the money matters.
Which is, are they paying you? And that's a whole nother thing.
But at some, like, people will say that too, like, yo, you know, the money doesn't matter right away. Do this for free. Just build up your portfolio.
What did I tell you? What did I tell you a long time ago? That is true to a point.
Yeah.
Because there's a point where it does matter, and there's a point where, you know, I always tell people when they come out of school, look, you're getting in this industry, do what you can, grind to about 20, I'd say probably 25, 23 to 25.
That's me.
You probably can grind, and then when you hit that point, you'll be like, no, I can't do this stuff for free anymore.
Oh, I've already done that.
Right, so it comes to that. What I was going to say is the two things that I think, and we got to wrap up, the two things that we have to look at in terms of jobs in this country, being jaded, especially media, is technology's changed stuff. Technology and media, in a weird way, has created more jobs, but not necessarily more jobs that people want to pay, which is your point, and you're right about that.
Yes, and a lot of them full time freelance. Oh, we'll you know, no benefits, but we'll give you X amount, or it's a lot of temps. A lot of places will be like, here, this is a fix. Another place where they don't want you, they just want to fill a role. Here's a 6-month fixed term for X amount of dollars. Yeah, you come in, you fill this, you go. We give it to the next person because we don't have to make this a full-time thing. Because God forbid we provide somebody with health care, dental, and all that stuff. 401k, et cetera, et cetera.
In the capitalistic society we're in, it benefits the company to be like that. It does not necessarily benefit the people. And that's the problem. When that happens, so it appears in media that there's more jobs, but there really isn't more jobs that are sustainable for people to live off of.
And that's why people keep moving from outlet to outlet.
Technology and a bit of capitalism has kind of cut jobs. So the thing that we have to look at in America, and this is kind of going in other places too, every company is trying to do more with less. This is what has happened throughout the newspaper industry. This is also what's currently happening. People try to act like TV is immune from it, but it's not. This is happening in TV. Everybody's doing more with less. So there's a lot of, in my industry, reporting on camera, people are sometimes shocked that I'm one-man banding. One-man banding, for people who don't know, means is I shoot, edit, and I do all the reporting on my stories by myself most of the time. I would say 95% of the time I'm doing that. That is a lot. We talk in music about people who rap and produce, right? And it's rarely are there people who do both extremely really well. Mm-hmm. When you're doing so many things, it's going to take away from you doing one thing really well. If I just had to report, I probably would just be better because I could focus on the craft of reporting. And because of that, I have to seek and try to do, and I'm working on people with more development work so I can be better at my craft. If I just worked it on editing, I'm just doing that. But because you have to do all three, there's three things you have to think about all at one time in doing it and make it great so you can be at a high level. Now, if you can do that well, it's good. But what people may not understand is it takes a lot of work to do that. What I'm saying is what happens then with that, you have workers that are more burnt out.
Yeah.
Who are not, you might think it's efficient and you're paying less people, but what is that doing to your people that you have employed? They are now more burnt out because they're doing more than they ever had before. That's the thing in media. Jobs appear that there are more jobs, but they're not really paying people to be sustainable.
They're not.
And people who are working the jobs are doing more than they ever had before.
Because
some of that has been good.
Right. Take photos, do social media.
Some of that has been good because it allows people to see and learn different things. But it does, I've always talked about this with older people in the industry, it does take away in some way from the stuff that people are doing. If you got to go to the store and you got to take pictures and you got to write, you can't just focus on the quotes and watching the game, it's going to affect what you're doing.
That's true.
You can't do it at the same level. If you just had to write and only focus on the game, well, now you're laser focused into that.
And if you're one-man band and you're going to be tired as fuck. Like when everything is done.
But a lot of times companies don't care about
everyone, as you said, everyone wants to get as much as they can for as little as they can. Everyone wants to cost cut, not pay as much. And that's what my concern is. I don't know if I see that changing. I don't know if I see it going the other way or sort of leveling out, balancing out, going back to the way things were before.
Here's what I think. I think that it's going to come to a burnout point. Because this is what I believe.
Well, we're probably close to that.
Yeah, I think we're close to that.
Because mental health now,
yes,
and that's a concern for a lot of people.
And I think that there is a push, and I was talking with my fiance about this, and I know you're a big fan of this. I think there's a huge push to go to the 4-day work week. I think that will come in our society.
Not 10-hour shifts a day, though.
There will be 10-hour shifts. But hey, look at the thing. Hold on. Their studies have shown, because people have done this already.
If you have the
4-day work week, I think it's a 4-hour work week. If you have the 4-day work week, 10-hour shifts, people are way more productive. You know why? They're more productive because they still know that they have that you put some of your people on working with Sunday through Thursday and other people working like Tuesday through Sunday. People know that they hang out. Think about how less stressed you are because you have a day where you can go handle your errands.
Yeah.
Go do stuff you need to do along with your regular weekend.
Yeah.
People would, trust me, you don't even think about it. You'd be much more willing to work 2 hours a day, to work one less day a week, and know that you have a full day stress-free that you can be like, okay, now I have this day to take care of stuff I need to.
I agree.
People are moving towards better work management. People are fighting for it.
Yeah.
People are rebelling against the system.
Yeah.
Studies, as younger people come into workplaces, they're saying, yo, this doesn't work. 5 days working 40 hours.
No, but that's the thing. And we discussed this on like episode 42 or whatever it was. That here's the thing. I agree that 4x10 is better than 5x8.
Oh, definitely.
But I think shifts are stupid. Period. Right? I think you having to absolutely no matter what fill this time void from 7 to 5, as opposed to which should be the main objective, getting your work done. And then being done with it, like that's ass backwards. That's hustling backwards.
I agree with you.
I think, because that's another point, that's another part of where companies just want to fill a void as opposed to be invested in you.
Good.
If they want to fill a void, then they will be like, listen, you have to sit here, do what you have to do from 7 a.m. to 5 p.m., 10-hour shift, and then, you know, go home, do what you got to do, as opposed to, look, we're invested in you. Come in here. Just do the work. Let's see what we can do today. Let's get after it. All right, we're done for the day. We'll pick back up tomorrow. Go home.
I think that you're going to see, and this is kind of getting another place, you will still always, the need for shifts will exist because so many things in finances work around business in the stock market. So you're always going to have things that are in that 9 to 5 time
frame.
Well,
I'm talking about more, creative stuff. Yeah, I think media and things like that.
I think in media and creative stuff, there will be that shift. That's the place I'm hopeful for it.
Yes.
There will be the shift where people will say, in fact, what they're going to say is our four 10-hour shifts a week are this arbitrary thing that we have. It's only in place to make sure that we ensure you have a third day off during the week. Yes. That's all that it means. Yes. It doesn't really mean that you have to do it. So if companies do that and they're like, hey, and you come in these hours, as long as you finish your work in these hours, we don't care. That's it. But it's just a structure to have that you ensure you get that third day.
Yeah.
That's what I'm concerned about. Give me that structure to ensure you have the third day. If those 10-hour shifts or whatever the time range of that is arbitrary and you do what you got to do in that, I agree with you. That's how it should be. That's what should matter.
Yeah.
I think younger, forward-thinking companies, more media companies are going to move to that. And I do. So it's funny. That's one of the things I'm hopeful for in our industry. I think as people fight for that, that's going to happen. So I think we'll be fine.
And this is where I think millennials should get some credit, because our generation just thinks of things differently than where traditionalists don't.
Yeah, right? Well,
and this is where, like, these things don't get pushed unless we just sort of wake up and we're like, you know what? No, let's just try this.
I think every generation's always been pushing. I just think this the millennials, our generation, has pushed more into, yo, there needs to be action. Like, why are we still continuing this trend that is stupid? There's always been nudging. There's always been people doing that. But I think there's really more of a stronger force in being that. And I think the next generation is going to take that even further. But we'll see. Main thing is, you can work in media, and it is, we talked about this before, it is hard as a minority, but you can't let them win. You got to find your space. You got to find your happy place, and you got to keep growing. I try to tell that to a lot of young minorities coming to this industry. Some of it is hard. You got to keep grinding. You got to find your space, and you got to create. Because when you create for yourself, can't nobody take that from you. Like we are doing right here.